What's up? Welcome to this first season of audio tutorials that I'm giving here on YouTube. In this first season, we're looking at dynamic processors, and in this episode, we're looking at compressors. Compressors are being used by audio recording studios throughout the world as a tool to shape the dynamics of an audio recording. Therefore, it could be categorized as a dynamic processor or a dynamic effect. Normally, a compressor is being used as an insert effect, and that means it will just affect one sound on the channel that is being inserted on. So for example, a compressor could be inserted onto a vocal track. Whereas the vocalist would get too loud, the compressor would automatically reduce the volume of that vocal track. Let's take a look at the compressor's basic overview. A compressor reduces the amount of level on an audio track, just like you would do with the fader on a mixing console. But the compressor does this a lot faster than you would be able to do this manually. The basic idea of a compressor is that you set a threshold. When the level of your audio signal reaches that threshold and gets over it, the compressor actually starts working and starts compressing. The amount of compression that takes place is what you set with the ratio, and that ratio determines the amount of compression above the threshold. I think you can clearly see that with this animation right here. So the easiest way to explain what a compressor does is to say that it makes loud sounds softer. That's what the traditional compressor does. So these are the first functions and settings of a compressor. First you start off with the threshold. Make sure that the level gets over the threshold or else the compressor won't work. So make sure that you lower the threshold if the compressor doesn't do anything. And the next step is to set the ratio, and that determines how hard the compressor works. So a ratio of 2:1 means that for every 2 decibels above the threshold, only 1 will be outputted by the compressor. And a ratio of 20:1 means for every 20 decibels above the threshold, only 1 will come out. So that's a hard compression type. And if you compare that with 2:1, that would be soft compression. And a ratio of 1:1 means basically for every 1 dB above the threshold, 1 will come out. So that's a neutral position and you will have no compression at all. Let's listen to a dynamic vocal track without any compression on it, and then compare that with a track where we actually apply compression on it so you can hear the difference.
We're gonna tear the roof off, we're taking it down, we take control to the people, revolution by sound. We're gonna tear the roof off, we're taking it down, we take control to the people, revolution by sound.
Here I'm playing an original drum track with no compression on it. And now compressed with ratio 2. Ratio 4. Ratio 10. And here we keep ratio 10, but we lower the threshold even more. As you could hear, the sound got a lot softer when we applied the ratio 10 at the end, especially when we lowered the threshold. That's because we just used the threshold and the ratio setting of this compressor, and I didn't look at any of the other settings yet. So what I haven't looked at yet is that we can now compensate the amount of compression or gain reduction that occurred by applying makeup gain or compensational gain, as whatever manufacturer would call that. So here's the original drums. And here we listen to the compressed drums, but with makeup gain. So we actually compress it with a ratio 10, and then we bring up the level to match the original input level. So what has happened here is that we reduced the amount of dynamic range. We made the loud sounds softer, a lot softer. So we brought them closer to the soft sounds, like the hi-hat. And then we brought up the volume of the overall drums back. So basically what we did is that we brought the soft sounds and the loud sounds closer together. And you can really hear that it sounds more aggressive in this way. So So now we've seen the most basic controls that a compressor has. That be the threshold, which sets the level at which it starts working, and then the ratio of how hard the compressor works on the signal that needs to be compressed. And then we have the makeup gain, which compensates for the amount of compression. There's two other things that are really important of setting up a compressor, and that is the so-called attack and release time. And these are settings which work on an amount of time set in milliseconds. Some compressors actually offer you an option fast attack or slow attack or auto release or these things, but it's always something similar to that. The attack time on a compressor determines how fast the compressor applies the compression when the signal gets over the threshold, where the release actually tells how long it takes for the compressor to stop compressing when the level drops below the threshold again. So that's basically the attack and release time. But they're really important of setting how fast will the compressor actually work. So if we got a snare drum and we set a compressor on it with a really slow attack time, the compressor will barely or probably not work at all because it's too slow. So the attack time determines how fast the compressor starts to work. I'm going to show you an example so you can hear and see it at the same time. I'm changing the attack time. And as I do that, you can really hear the effect on the kick and the snare drum, especially in the plunge. And that concludes part one of the first tutorial about compression techniques. In part two, I'm really gonna look at how to set up a compressor and how they're being used. I'm gonna look at different compressor techniques like New York drum compression, sidechain compression, and all these other types of things. And in part three, I'm even gonna compare a lot of different brands of compressors and really hear the distinct sound of each one. So I hope you learned something today. See y'all in part two and part three. You should be able to see the links right here. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos.